Well, a State of Decay is a good game. It's a good game.
You say it.
It's a fucked up, messed up game.
Yeah, I've never played it.
But it's a good game.
I mean, a 360 game looks pretty jank.
This game, the PC version, is also very jank.
It's not an updated version.
Well, it is somewhat updated. So,
all right,
it's X to attack and B to defend.
All right, we start right in the middle of this, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
You're killing your zambies.
How strong are zambies?
They're pretty weak individually. So your stamina is your blue meter.
You okay? Okay.
And your health is your red.
One of those psychos tried to bite me, but yeah. Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah, this game looks terrible now. Yeah. Damn, sir.
Ranger station?
Ranger station. How easy is it to die?
Maybe we can find some help.
Just give me the straight up loadout.
Averagely easy to die, I would say. Right?
Does it take like a sort of like a knockdown state of some kind?
So there you go. You can hold LB and hit Y to do a finishing move.
Okay.
Which is
only
good.
When they're downed.
Yeah. Which is good because otherwise it's genuinely hard to kill them with just smashing them with shit.
Now running up to individual zombies, big deal or no? Like avoid
trivial.
Okay.
Trivial deal for individual zombies.
D-pad. Does that actually pause the game state?
Doesn't no.
Seem like it.
The events page keeps a log of stuff that happens. So this is basically like a fucking activity log.
Yep, okay.
So your vacation was over and you went home and then you found this shit.
Okay, and so that's where
yeah, so now you can hit
calls for help and
yeah, then this guy tries to get bitten and you're just
weapon durability.
I believe it exists, but I don't remember.
Okay. Hold up.
Now, as you can see from that zombie jumping to his feet like that and then flying backwards, this game is jank. There you go.
Oh, it's broken. Oh, no, it's not. It just goes away.
Yeah, it just goes away. So you can hold B, and then you'll crouch. It makes you, like, genuinely more difficult to see on your Zambambos. Oh, yeah, see you see the yellow stick icon on the left?
Yeah.
That means your stick's, like, getting breaking.
Okay. And, I guess... Is there, like, a state where they can, like, tackle you and, like, make your life...
Like that? Yes. Oh, you can fuck them up there. So your buddies will help you. So death
you,
it...
You can lose a buddy, too.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, no, you can lose everybody. You can lose yourself.
Of course you can lose yourself.
So the basic gimmick on this one, Wolves, and why it's so interesting to me, is that this game is a single-player... permadeath game.
There's a lag on when you rotate the camera to when it actually moves. Like, check it out.
Yeah.
You hear, you feel like...
Yeah.
Alright.
Basically, your character, if killed, you will just spawn as your next character, but you'll lose all your shit.
But in the same area of the world, right? It's not like anywhere on the map type of thing.
Pardon?
Like, there's still a location and a story and a, like, a progression of
and
events.
And you switch characters. Like, basically, you earn a bunch of characters as you get, like, new areas. And you will,
Man, can anybody tell me what the hell is going on?
These guys explain.
What's going on is there's more of them up here than I expected. We need to sweep the rest of the cabins for survivors. But I've got injured people here I have to tend to.
Okay. We'll see what we can do.
We will? I appreciate it. There's a water tower out back that has a good view of the campgrounds. Might be worth your while to climb up there and have a look around first. We've got some supplies in the locker.
So everyone
here
has been in this shit for a while now.
Yes, and you just came back from vacation or whatever.
Vacation. Like.
So yeah, you can zoom out somehow. There you go. There you go. So it's a relatively large map.
That's a zone.
The main thing is that this is basically a single-player DayZ.
Which I've also never played.
Well, yeah, no. Never play that. That's a bad game.
Okay.
He's
hurt.
That's your buddy. He's hurt.
He's so getting healed, though.
You can pick all these bros.
Okay. Thomas.
Thomas Ritter.
Father figure. Enjoys camping. Born leader. Like to travel.
So what that is that when you, have everybody back at camp... Their stats will determine what they're good at. Like some guys have better area defense, some people are better at cooking, etc. You have all these stats per character.
That you level up.
That you level up.
Okay. Actual skills.
Yeah.
And
That is for your base building mechanic.
Okay.
Where you're building up a safe house. And this is your current safe house. And all it has is a medical area.
So when I went to select my buddy there, it was just kind of like looking at his stats and such. Or am I actually like pulling him out?
The page portrait selected and use the D-pad to highlight specific. Blah, blah, blah. You can use the D-pad to manage. Yeah, it doesn't look like you can switch people
I'm
yet.
Not switching to him.
Yeah.
No, okay. All right.
This is the only game that I can think of a sufficient quality that was like, hey, do you want to play a single player round, like rummage through town
right.
kind of fucking like zombie game? And it's got a lot of cool near. Oh, so what that is, that's kind of a shop in almost all other situations, but since it's the tutorial, it's fine. So the deal is that your character builds up influence mm-hmm. with the rest of the party.
Mm-hmm.
Like at the safe house, and that allows them to take stuff out of the supply cabinet.
Oh, but okay.
So your currency is trust.
Ah, interesting. Okay.
Because
if you go out,
think about this.
Yeah.
Hey, Jimmy's just grabbing all the guns.
Yeah. No, of course. Totally. All right. So how do I now?
So your safe zone is that small circle there, like on your minimap.
Yeah.
Which you've temporarily cleared out.
Okay,
so you check your map, you should be able to see the wall. Oh, there it is. There's the water tower.
So switching items here, just in case my stick breaks.
You can hit start and we can go into the controls and see how the fuck to do that. There you go, controls.
Yeah.
Turbo is LB.
Hey, what?
Turbo.
Like NBA Jam?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, Turbo is run, but it's also the the modifier button for all your moves.
Okay. Sure.
So, like, you have a bunch of special melee moves that you'll learn, and, like, you currently have LB and Y that will be, like, stomp a guy when he's down.
Okay. Is there a real-time day-night
sure
system?
Sure is.
Okay, so taking too long.
There's also a real-time you're-not-playing-the-game system in which the events of the game will continue to play out even when you're not playing it.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
So, if, like, I remember taking a week off from playing this game, and I came back, and one guy was dead, and like everybody was mad.
Oh shit!
And I was like, "What the fuck?"
It's like too long.
Well, you're dead. Good job.
Not now.
No, that's not how that works. It is not. It is not like one single goddamn bite, and you're done.
I was about to say like that would have been really dumb.
That would have been super hardcore.
Okay, so you're referring to this area.
Yeah, so you're basically... you also have a... your minimap will show, like, a zombo on your map behind you.
Well, there's only one, I hear.
Yeah.
One right there.
Oh, there he is.
Oh, you can climb?
Yep.
Okay.
They can climb. Your buddy Ed's the shit.
All right.
And if I remember correctly, I think there's a sound... Oh, there is a sound meter as well. Oh wow, you took a lot of damage.
Going
that.
Straight for the stomp, huh? Not yes. a good idea. Uh-oh.
No, they have to be downed for the stomp to kick over. Okay. There you go.
Okay.
You do have, like, a sound meter, and right now it's not all that, like, what would I call it? Important? But, like, shit like flying through that window you see on your minimap and made this huge, like, exploding circle of noise.
Yeah.
Firing a gun is this is the game firing a gun is your
huge
absolute
problem.
Dead last resort.
Yeah.
Because it will cause you a problem.
Alright, you come through here. Oh no.
Yeah, so the basic idea is that your minimap is like supposed to be your peripheral awareness or whatever.
Okay. Cause I wanted to not bait too long today there. Is it
No shit.
Just beating with the normal melee.
So you've cleared your cabin.
Up here with the last of the tequila until this all blows over.
Somehow I doubt it.
Yeah, me too.
Pickupables, grabbables, actual grabbables.
Okay. I believe. There's. So in the upper left, it's telling you
nothing left.
There is literally nothing in this thing.
So like I noticed that if I don't do the stomp, I can just swing until they're dead.
But it takes like
more
nine swings.
Yeah.
And the issue isn't so much stamina
right, we don't want any
as it is time, because this is a pretty, like, generous area right. In the early game. You're deep in the woods, you have long sight lines.
Any kind of lock on? No, eh?
No. And you also notice that you cleared out that cabin, and that cabin's now completely free.
This one, though.
That will change over time. So the longer you leave an area unsecured, the, what do you call it? Yeah, the longer you leave an area unsecured, the more likely it'll become unsafe again.
Okay.
So what you can do is, for a little while, you can clear out the mini mark.
Is he gonna come in or no? He's just not gonna come in.
Yeah, he's kicking the shit out of those guys.
Okay. Oh, you can build barricades on windows.
Yeah, you can do all sorts of shit in this
game. If you want to hang out for a while.
So yeah, now you go around
and
you search shit.
Got it. Oh.
So you hold LB to turbo your search, but it will make more noise.
But right now I'm making a little bit of noise.
Yeah, tiny, tiny little baby noise.
Okay.
Mostly quiet.
Numbs the pain, and what was that first one? Just food?
Stamina boost, yeah.
Stamina, okay. Alright.
And you also get, you straight up get, like, that search progress. It's like, no, stop searching the house. You found everything in the fucking house.
So saving is, I guess, going back to base?
Not really.
No?
Saving is stopping the game.
Oh, okay.
Sure. It uses the Dark Souls save mentality.
You stopped right now, and that's all there is to it. Okay.
I can't remember, but I think if you leave your guy out in the middle of nowhere, that they're likely to get fucking killed, though.
Okay. Do you actually find, like, clothing?
I think that's about all there is to find here.
It's been, like, 3 or 4 years since I played this game, honestly. But the primary thing that I remember is that it's fucking dope.
Okay. I want to switch to my axe.
People's page shows different shit.
Gunshots.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. Guess we're not the only ones.
So yeah, broken windows are the things you can barricade, and I believe you can also barricade doors under if they're smashed to shit.
I'm not equipped with my axe. Oh boy, that was great.
Oh, don't worry about that. Don't worry about that.
There we go. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna take a second there.
The controls are goofy. The controls are goofy. The movement is bad, and the graphics are poor.
But it's a good game.
But it's a good game. And it's a good game that was very frustrating to me. Because when I played it, I had a fucking 970, and I could hear my fucking, I could hear my video card screaming.
Oh, boy.
And, like, it was making noise, and I was like, no, you're not supposed to do that. That's too much. So this is your ranger station, which was supposed to be safe.
But it's not.
But it's not.
Oh, boy.
Yo, yo, yo.
Alright, so what happened, bro?
Come with me and watch my back, or... Oh, he won't come back with you.
No matter what happens.
Yeah, so never mind.
Hey, don't be a stranger.
So check your map. I think you're missing one of the cabins you're supposed to look for. Yeah, see? Climb the water tower.
Okay. It did tell me to go back, though. So I did have to go back and save these guys.
Sorry, can't really talk right now.
Okay.
I don't think you had to go back, actually.
Well, all right.
Like... You could have just let them fend it off on their own.
And risk
with
dying
whatever.
With my newfound friends?
So the thing is to your south.
All right.
Yeah. That's the distant gunshots. And it happens to be next to the water tower.
Oh, let me set me a little waypoint.
There you go.
Yeah, no, I assumed it was like a... Oh, I assume at any point it's like, go do this, otherwise people die. It's always going to be held over my head.
So one of the things that... Well, yes. That is absolutely the case. But also, if you're doing something important, you can be like, nah, fuck it. So one of the things is that when you were searching the cabin, it also told you what kind of materials you're likely to find there. That's because items will rarely, like over time, repopulate themselves. So that you can actually do it.
Okay.
But there is an item that in my time playing, I don't know if it either repopulates incredibly slowly or it doesn't.
Uh-huh.
And that's cars.
Oh, really? Vehicles exist.
Vehicles exist all over the place, but if you get in a car, fuck it up, and crash it,
that's it.
You find a new car.
Yeah, yeah. Also, I'm assuming the sound is going to be a huge problem.
When you're driving, you're constantly emitting this enormous amount of noise.
Awesome. I like that.
And the faster you go, the more noise you make. But they are stuck at this pace. Oh, that is fantastic.
Good axe. So is that just because of the amount of time?
Level 2 fighting. You've increased.
Nice. I guess I just took a bit of time going through this camp.
Yep.
And so it's not just inside the tent. It's the whole area counts.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, okay. You leveled up a skill. Hit up on your D-pad and view your new abilities.
And I'm guessing I can level up.
Oh, nice! Bigger backpack!
Yeah, inventory was about to... I was about to ask. Okay.
So now you can go into your inventory and throw on your bigger backpack.
Okay, so right away, this should make more space.
Yep.
I can toss this. Or is it adding?
I wouldn't toss anything. And no, it's not adding. The bigger backpack, the reason why it says it's bulky, I believe it also inflicts your stamina with a slight penalty.
Okay.
So yeah, you can go into fighting. So you got bonus vitality.
Okay. Powerhouse leadership. But yeah. Okay. Great.
And if you go right, RB one more. Okay. Fine. Okay. So eventually, you start to unlock new moves, like a larger moveset.
Oh, combat moveset.
So
okay.
Like a guy that has like maxed out fighting, when you hold LB, they'll have a move for every face button, and they're awesome. It's kind of Dead Rising-y. In that respect.
Nice.
So yeah, counterattack, and then you start to work on your melee specialization.
Nice.
And then you get your special technique.
And weapon types are all just pretty much swinging stuff. That's pretty much it.
Melee weapons and guns.
Yeah, okay.
Like that, and car.
But you're not getting like an axe-specific moveset or anything.
No, but you can melee specialize in like edge weapons and shit like that.
Okay, so how do I pump a point into this?
You don't have to.
It just happens.
Yeah.
You
learn as you do it.
The thing you do. Oh, okay, yeah, all right. I get that.
So you will end up having a scenario in which, like this guy, hey, I'm gonna go into a place where I'm gonna have to rock and like punch some heads.
Head towards the gunshots. Is that a good idea?
Yes.
Is there a fall distance?
Don't remember. But I don't think it would be extreme if it was. Oh, it was extreme.
Here they come.
Wow, there's significant fall damage.
Oh, that's... We can't survive that.
That's crazy.
Can we?
Yeah, you can do it.
Three people can do that? Okay.
Yeah, three people can do that.
All right, let me get closer and then...
So, one zombie is absolutely trivial, okay? 10 zombies with a party of your bros.
What's the stamina punishment for running out?
You will, I believe, not just be able to do actions once you completely run out.
All actions or just swinging?
Swinging and actions.
I can walk and run.
Yeah.
Attacked by psychopaths and watching two of my best friends die? Yeah, I'm Peachy.
Sorry I asked.
So, is it this bad everywhere?
Oh, yeah, no.
I hope not. We got some survivors.
So this is one of those games that you play, you're like, wow.
We didn't have time for orientation.
Boy, do I just want a sequel. Well, then, I don't even want to play this one. I just want the sequel right now.
You know video games. Me? Oh,
they're
boy.
Setting up an infirmary in there. Like, why
I think you healed on your own.
To a hospital or something?
Huh.
I don't know, man. Whole situation's pretty messed up.
You think? What's next? Razor wire and guard towers?
Okay, so the joke is that, yes, the next idea is razor wire and guard towers.
Right.
Like, explicitly. So up and then LB is your home base. So that's all you got. You got your ranger station. All it has is your medical area.
And from here I can choose...
So, and every...
No, actually, I can't.
Well, because you're not in charge at the ranger base.
Okay. All right. And now I can switch off.
Now you can change character.
But I have the axe, so maybe I should stick with it.
Marcus is fine.
Can I give them better weapons or whatever?
I don't... Yes, but I don't remember how.
All right, well, then I fell off the path. So let's see here.
I think you get to follow the road, man.
Yeah, I got to hoof it.
Yeah.
All right, we go home.
And hit your map, and it'll show you. It'll give you the ability to hit a waypoint. Yeah. So you notice all those cabins are no longer safe?
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's how quickly
okay.
Yeah. So the idea that you will clear out an area consistently, ridiculous.
Yeah. Because, like, I remember thinking, like, when I was playing, like, FF15, that, like, I'd be like, oh, I'll pick up all the items in this area, and they'll be gone forever, and then I'll collect everything. It's like, you are never going
never.
To do that. The moment you turn the camera, another one has spawned. So, yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah. So that there was the path you could have taken.
I'm assuming later on there's going to be, like, multiple prompts for your attention. and you choose who you're going to run to? Or
depends. So, I don't know if we're going to get, because we'd have to play multiple hours to see all the stuff, but what you can do is you can send people out on missions, right? You go, hey, buddy, I recently cleared out the McDonald's, right? Go down to the McDonald's. Wasn't quite perfect there. Go down to the McDonald's, get some food, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you can be out doing your thing, and then you'll get a call on your radio that goes, I'm in some serious bullshit right now.
Mm-hmm.
And so what happens is that the character will basically, it's not like a like the Assassin's Creed kind of Facebook game way of doing it, where you set them on a timer and they just flitter off into nothing. Right?
They actually
the
go
character
to that place.
Goes.
That's a real thing. Okay.
And comes back. And if at any point the character decides that the situation they're in is too fucked, they will barricade themselves somewhere or what have you and call for help, and you will probably have to go get them.
Interesting.
Lest lose their supplies, lose that character,
right,
people
okay.
get upset, that kind of thing.
Okay. All right, let me try the stealth out over time.
And there's a bunch of different bases. So we're playing the base game, which is, has like a pretty linear progression, but there is a DLC. There you go. That basically is like free roam and just pick any location in any order. Because as you go through the game, like you get better locations, and you can have multiple of them going at once, but it gets harder and harder to maintain them.
This safe area can still totally, like...
Yes.
Get run over. Like, if they hop that fence and come back with me, then...
And that's why the ranger station sucks.
Uh-huh.
Because it doesn't have any hard barricades.
And I can oh, yeah. I can actually lead zombies back into the house.
Yes.
Okay.
So, you're the kind of person, Wooly, that I imagine once you got a new settlement... The very first thing you would do is man people on the guard towers
instantly.
They were fine just a minute ago.
Well, obviously not anymore.
Guys.
Jesus.
Come on. We gotta at least check the place. Somebody might have survived.
Not having a walkie-talkie is pretty shitty in these scenarios.
Oh, yeah. It makes me want to get a walkie-talkie.
Someone might have survived. It's a small room, dude.
He's checked. Gone.
Yeah.
I like that these people all had their the fronts of their torsos ripped off.
Well, let's see if he's got a wallet on him or something.
Like, it's really extreme.
To check his ID, for Christ's sake.
Oh, no! And this is... And just stand there.
Stand there and watch it.
No, save Ed!
Help me!
You saved him.
He's still, like...
That guy was dead. I swear
Thomas
to God,
is dead.
That guy, he was dead.
Yeah, you know this.
How the hell does that happen?
I don't know, man.
So taking
sense.
A bite is not a problem.
We can't stay here. Come on, let's grab what we can.
Then what's the actual problem?
Taking a canonical bite, I imagine, is a problem, actually.
Okay, because...
Honestly, I don't remember the specifics.
Because in a world where the zombie rule is, like, really loose...
Yeah.
...and you don't actually get infected from a single bite,
mm-hmm.
that spread is way slower, and the apocalyptic scenario is gonna be delayed.
I believe in State of Decay, the apocalyptic scenario is like, oh, you leveled up to Powerhouse, level 2.
All right.
Let's see if you got any moves from it.
All right, there's a zombie over here.
Yeah, but they'll handle it.
Okay.
Your guys are actually...
Pretty competent. While I look at my moves.
So it'd be the basics.
Nope, not a 3 yet.
What about Powerhouse? Because that's the one you leveled up.
Me and a couple guys from the unit came up here to do some deer hunting.
Yeah, there it is.
Are you in the army?
Okay, you got strong bat.
You don't
yeah,
miss much,
okay.
Do you?
So I believe you're going to be
on our way back when
you picking one of these.
Gotcha.
Click on whichever one you want.
No, it's not a pick. It's
just increase. So yeah, you get a lot of abilities over time.
Okay. All right.
So now it's time for you to just
escape.
Escape, head to that safe little spot on the map.
It did say talk to her when I want to do
Yeah, so all you did now you can just literally
let her rest.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, let's see what this does.
And now you got her.
Alright. Now you've got a shotgun and an axe.
Yep.
Okay, bullets are bad though.
bullets are not only... You know, you're deep in the woods. Fire a gun and see what happens to your mini-map.
Of course. Now, we haven't seen a shooting tutorial yet.
Yeah.
I guess we just head to town and try to find somebody.
Yeah.
I hit your map. Make sure you're going in the right direction. Uh-huh. Yeah, you're following the road.
Took that guy's walkie-talkie. Maybe we can raise somebody on that.
Jesus, Ed, why did you do that?
I don't know. I figured if he had a radio, there must be somebody on the
Everyone's
other
mad at him so for stealing shit. And you expect his there's a car over there.
Oh, who would be...
His friends.
That's insane.
I mean, didn't even really like the guy.
Who would be this far into the apocalypse and actually start complaining about stealing?
Shit. I know, right?
Where'd you see the car? Sorry?
To the bottom of your minimap.
The icon.
Listen,
over there.
Yeah. We're stuck up here on Mount Tanner. My friend needs medical attention. Can you help us?
I think that's
a
car.
Can you make it down to Spencer's Mill? Some of us are holed up at the church.
Clearly it is.
If your friend doesn't look too dicey, we'll let you in.
The church in Spencer's Mill. We're on our way. We'll,
That's gas.
Try not to look too dicey.
That. There you go. You found a car.
And an actual... Yeah.
Little bit of zombies.
All right. Is there a way to draw them out and make some noise?
So I believe if you hold LT, you'll just aim your gun. Because your ammo is appearing above your head immediately.
Yeah.
So just hit LT, let me... Like, Yeah, that's the... So, your gun and melee, it's not switching between. It is always available at all times. Because... When you make the decision to shoot your gun, it will be a quick decision.
Right. Time to set that up.
I literally cannot get out of this house unless I start shooting this gun.
That's fine. Yeah, you can take that for now. Not a ton of space, and the weight also matters.
You have a maximum. So you have your inventory slots, which is your total number of different items, and then you have your pounds, which is a hard cap.
All right.
So there's a bunch of different resources. You got medical supplies. You got gas.
Nothing left.
You got bullets, like general ammunition. Which, when you stockpile ammo at the house, when people defend yourself from zombies, they will be using ammunition.
Okay.
It is not free to put people up on your guard post.
Friendly fire is a thing.
I don't remember.
You can't break through that stuff.
No. And as you can see, as soon as you started to drive the car.
Okay. Hit him off. Oh boy.
Holy, for fuck's sake.
This thing handles like shit, man.
So hit square to knock them off the car door.
Okay. Let's try this again with some clearance.
I want to point out that,
the turning is fucking...
You left Ed back there.
He didn't get in?
He got pulled out.
I didn't even see it.
Oh!
Can he die like that?
Maybe.
Get in. Why doesn't he get in? Okay, how do I get out?
No, there you go. There you go. Go. Go now.
Dude, the car is terrible.
I know.
You know how bad this is.
I know. So look at your map. Look what's happening to your mini map as you drive.
Sound.
Just so much.
Yeah, I see it. Oh no! We're okay though.
It's actually completely fine.
All right.
Oh man, it's a lot of crazy.
Let's see if we can find a way around. No,
not that way.
Oh boy. Knock him off. I have to do it. No, I can only do my side.
Yeah, you can only do your side.
I just have to hope that they do it properly.
The best way to do it is usually to scrape them off.
That actually makes a difference. Okay. Oh, we're smoking up now, aren't we?
Yeah.
I don't know, mate. Looks like we could climb up over here, maybe?
Looks like you lost your car.
All right. Where's the climb spot? Over here.
Yeah, right here.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, you were never going to get anywhere with that car.
That was completely pointless, but thanks for the tutorial.
So they can climb after you on shit like this.
Are you guys coming?
Well, he's helping out.
All right.
You did it.
Come on. He's hurt.
Yes, he's very clearly, like, storyline infected for real.
Storyline hurt.
Yeah.
Not, like, I can help him hurt.
No.
I can't help him?
No, he's in an injured state.
Okay.
Like, there's a...
Usually
there,
there's it is.
Basically, it's your health is low, but there's also, like, your ankle is broken, or you're mauled, or whatever.
And can I spend one of my meds on him?
What the hell's happening?
I don't think so right now.
Oh, look, another vehicle.
Isn't that convenient?
Guess you could say we've been out of the loop.
All we know is a bunch of crazy people.
You're going pretty far.
It started, what, 12, 13 days ago? At first, it was just...
You're going pretty far.
Random maulings, violent incidents at hospitals, black helicopters in the sky. Just strange stuff.
I like how they clip through each other.
Indeed.
As they get into that car.
Boy, the jank is real.
Jank's very real. So careful you don't hit that car.
I told you that. Lest the alarm go off, I guess. That might be a good thing. Everything controls the exact same.
Of course it does.
It's really okay.
Why would it control differently? What kind of game do you think this is?
They said the Z word.
So. Yeah, they did say the Z word, which is awesome to me.
All right, let's try this.
It works.
Cool.
Yeah, no, by far the best solution to that problem is scraping them off.
Physics, actually.
Yeah. And your car does take damage from slamming into them.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
But turns out the car is the strongest weapon in the game, because the car is the only thing you can use to kill, like, 1,000 of them
in a row.
In a row.
Yeah, okay.
If you're willing to junk that car forever. And if you junk that car forever in a bad spot, that can fuck you, because if you T-bone some shit in the middle of the street, that you make it like that over there, you can actually make it so that it's going to be a hard ass time to drive through.
The amount of abandoned cars with gas in it in their tanks is
they are all her father and stole his radio. They are all fine.
That's
and abandoned.
Completely ridiculous. I'll just follow the road there.
Yeah.
Okay.
You did it.
This is the zone. This looks like a real place a little bit.
Yeah, this looks like a bunch of places. That's the way to the church right there, through that,
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, just in time for our car to fall the fuck apart.
Good job.
Can I tuck and roll out of this bitch?
You can.
No need to.
There you go. So this ends up in a weird thing. It's like, you want to bring the car back, obviously, so that it works.
But the sound is
But
Lily, do you invite these strangers?
Looks like it'd be easier to just grab a new car. Good. Anyway.
You made it.
That one doesn't look so good.
Name's Ed. Pleased to meet you.
Come with me, son. We'll see to those.
God damn it! We got enough trouble without bringing in another freeloader.
Oh, there's always got to be a devout one.
There's always... you're at a church.
I offered them shelter. I'm letting them in. Us freeloaders have to stick together.
But just for the sake of, like, clashing human profiles.
Yeah, it's like, no, there's going to be the guy
who's like, the atheist.
Can we all just chill out?
Right. The pragmatists. Yeah.
So there's also a bunch of features that
that was awesome.
Very poorly understand that have to do with your friends list on Steam.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, whatever to that. Meh.
So you have a new home.
For now.
So this place has...
What?
Oh, you're supposed to follow the person, and they'll show everything off.
Jesus Christ.
That was the most dire...
oh my god, already! Welcome to the church! Ah, it's run over! Like, fucking calm down.
Chill out, everybody.
Okay, so I have to take the tour. Got it.
I spend most of my time here, using the radio to coordinate everyone.
No one cares. Tell me where the shit is, and tell me...
You can't just take all their shit, man.
Supplies.
That's fucked up to do.
Supplies.
That's a fucked up thing to do, just steal all their stuff.
Surprise! Supplies. There we go. Yeah, bigger backpack.
But encumbered. Now you're encumbered.
Encumbered! I like that word.
And you'll gain influence by putting stuff
in
there.
It's not a bigger backpack. It's the same size.
It's the
backpack.
Same backpack.
So then I should. I don't need this.
Yeah.
You said don't get rid of it, but what's the point of it?
This is a different character. You just pulled it out of the supply locker.
But what I mean is, if I have two backpacks, what's the point of that?
Well, you can put one into the goddamn supply locker and gain influence. Next up's the because other people can
putting
use it.
Things in the supply
yeah,
locker.
Yeah, it's a store. Well, there's only so it's much just instead of money, it's price. Influence.
Gotcha.
Seriously though.
So yeah, put it back in there.
All the food stays in here and
see?
It stays
Okay.
You wouldn't believe
what if I put in my old one?
Otherwise.
Well, then you would lose all your shit because that's what that is what all of it's equipped in.
Okay. It's gonna. I didn't completely understand how that worked, but yeah, I get it now. So pick up random shit, drop it in there.
Yep.
And keep the good shit
sleeping
for yourself.
Hope you don't mind sharing.
And the supply closet, the supply thing is where they're going to pull shit like meds and ammo from.
Okay. And he says we could build like a dorm room or something to get more space.
Barricading
How
uses
many people do you have here?
Some of my materials up there.
Just about everybody,
I believe
except
so.
Except maybe my brother and my dad.
So you got food, medical supplies, generalized ammunition.
I haven't heard from them
that
in a
fourth
while.
One, I don't remember the Rest fuck it is.
Bricks and gas.
And building supplies. And the last one is gas. All of those are going to be used for various things at your base. So food is pretty simple. You need that. If you do not have that, you will have problems immediately.
How quickly does it go down?
Not that quickly, but it is a just like when you're out, get food, bring it back.
Forget to entertain strangers.
Oh, this guy that voices Kana in Pillars of Eternity, huh? I've never heard him in anything else.
How do I check his like fucking
his dope stats?
The back of his card.
God bless.
Yeah.
You go into your D-pad menu.
Would he already be here?
Yes.
Well, he can't. Okay, I can't do it right now when that prompts up. Oh yeah. Okay. Everyone in the camp shows up here. Gotcha.
They all have their different stats, like team player or preacher. He loved literature, but he's got a bum knee.
Well, fuck that then.
So there's a guy on your team that has chronic fatigue.
Oh boy. Let's see, where was that? Oh yeah.
And Lily is actually like operating
but
the radio.
Fucking 6-star gossip general ready to start some shit.
That's why you want her on the radio.
I see.
What's up?
So you still gotta follow Lily before you can unlock like the remainder of the roaming objectives.
So and I gotta pick some good partners. Or go back to my original character.
Well,
she's got a gun.
You don't have enough influence to have a whole posse with you.
Yeah.
So when you have enough influence, you can be like,
I didn't want to say this in front of your friends.
I want three people with me at all times.
Especially
after right?
A bite.
But if you're completely by yourself, do you know what doesn't happen?
Mm-hmm.
You don't get into fights that you could avoid.
Okay.
Because you're going to you can stealth it. You can,
of course.
And that's I actually think that's a good way of moving around like subpar or average AI. It's like, listen, the AI is just going to do what the AI is going to do, right? It's tough to complicate to make stealthy AI like a priority. So it's just like, no, you want to be really quiet? Go by yourself,
because
Jimmy's going to step on a broken bottle and go, and cause you everybody to get fucking killed.
I can dig that. So here's a question. I took control of her, and now these two are having their conversation about shooting my friend because he's infected.
Yeah.
How often do I switch characters, and or rather... Like,
as soon as this is over, you'll be able to switch to anyone that you have available at your base.
And like, the person that I put on point, it doesn't really actually matter.
Well, their stats and their abilities matter.
But
story? No.
Okay. Sure.
So whoever I'm in control of will just be the person.
Think of them as Darkest Dungeon party members.
Right, okay.
They are disposable.
Yeah, the camera and me, the nomad soul,
yes.
Is what matters.
Fuck you. Fuck you, you bastard.
Now, and the only other thing then is the fact that, like, don't take shit you haven't earned. All right, well, yeah, you say that.
They go to the supply, you're... There you go.
You lost me. There's a cell tower behind the swine and bovine. From up there, you should be able to get a good look at the town. Maybe you'll spot some place to find medicine.
So basically, your first mission here is going to be
I'm
a scouting
sure how long
thing.
I can rein Alan in.
I don't need anything from there.
All right. So hit your map. All right. See your new map location, dead center in the middle of town?
Yep.
That's what you're going to want to do.
Great.
So you can walk or drive there, your choice.
Yeah.
They both have pretty significant advantages over one another.
These are closed windows.
Yep.
Okay, so jumping through them.
Now, what you can do is jump through them like an asshole.
Yeah.
and smash them to fucking bits.
Make a ton of noise, break our barriers, all that fun stuff. No, what I was going to ask is because, like, if I'm building up a character by getting my combat up.
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, here comes a better guy who's just already better.
Switch.
That's it.
Yeah. But, oh, Alan's dead.
He's sad. He's not dead. Loss of hope. Okay. Don't be sad.
Alan is sad and he's bringing everyone down.
Well then, come with me. Don't bring everyone down.
No, you can't.
I can't.
First of all, he's on guard duty on the watchtower. So you want to leave him there. And second of all, I don't think you don't have the ability yet. You don't have enough influence to drag people out of the base with you.
So don't grab anybody that's on
no.
duty?
No. You're going to be, for the beginning part of the game, you're going to be going your lonesome.
Well, not minus that tutorial, I suppose.
Yeah. All right. So yeah, you can either walk there, which is basically just going through the backyards of the suburbs, or you can drive.
That's not...
Oh!
Woo!
So that...
Woo!
...is an infestation.
Okay.
So, that is an anti-safe zone. Okay?
Okay?
That is an area that is so bad that it's making the zone around it worse.
A new group of survivors.
Okay. Here's how bad is that zone spread besides...
Okay, so go back to your map again.
The church anyways?
So there's a survivor up at the top of the map.
Yep.
There's an infestation to the lower, and then there's your story thing, which is the watchtower over here. And that's a roaming horde.
Oh, like a horde of, like, a pack of them.
Yeah.
And they have a vision cone.
They have a vision cone like it's Metal Gear.
Okay. Okay.
And now, this is the game.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, this got a little bit harder immediately.
The instant you get that base, you're done with your tutorial, and the game is proper unlocked. So you can actually pretty safely check those guys out, and...
The horde can hear you?
Yeah, they can hear you, and they can also mostly see you with their vision cone. So those bushes make you absolutely invisible if you're inside them. Well...
Oh, he already saw me.
Yeah, I already saw you. So I believe you also have a push move, which should be LB with Y when you're not, like, over a guy.
Okay. Alright, so I can safely observe the horde, you're saying?
Yeah, so if you get behind them, you should be able to safely observe them shambling down the road. And they move pretty slowly. You can fuck up and drag them back to your base. So you see that?
Yeah.
So
yeah.
With one person...
Oh, boy.
That's a problem.
Yeah.
Right?
And
with five people... Okay, now you got two infestations.
Ooh, that changed real quick. All right. And that's way close to my objective, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, I see the difficulty ratcheted the fuck up and just...
And so basically the primary game right now is going to be... Scavenge for supplies. Build up the facilities at your base. Make your character stronger. Do story missions here and there to unlock more of the game. And just keep the loop going. Like,
okay. Now, if your horde gets detects you, and you sprint back to your safe house...
They'll follow you. Sometimes that's good. So, you've discovered confident survivors, in which they have actually cleared the zone out around their house.
Okay.
And they're totally fine.
But like, ultimately, if finding...
No. Wait, I am at... They should...
That... What are you talking about?
Well, why is this listed as a safe spot?
Those are zombies, buddy. And that's a lot of them for one person.
Are they upstairs, then? Is that what that is?
Is there a way to get upstairs without...
Yeah, there was a staircase to your left.
Without... Okay, well, we'll just have to sneak it, won't we? No, so what I'm asking is, if I can...
Because these guys... There's a trust meter in here, for fuck's sake.
So there's got to be someone. And build a barricade, yeah. Why would you build a barricade with the zombies inside the house? The system is confusing me.
Yeah, well... It's not a perfect game.
That's where... That's the RNG, huh? Okay. Alright, so no. If the zombies find you in a horde...
They'll all aggro simultaneously.
Running towards your safe house is a bad idea, so then what the fuck do you do?
Well, there's a couple things you can do. Okay.
No one's in here.
Yeah, that's super weird, actually.
Okay.
They should not be in here, but hey, game's not perfect. Kind of buggy, even.
All right, well, let's just pretend.
Yeah.
Never happened.
All right, yeah, you get out of here. Unless they're, like, on the outside of the fucking building.
Really? Is that a thing?
Maybe.
Oh, now they all see me.
Ah, well. So running makes a little bit more noise. So there is a... You can see there's a wild difference between how some of them move and how others of them move. Right?
Yeah.
Like, it is... No, I wouldn't call it random. There are different types.
Erratic.
I've been thinking about a lot of stuff lately, and something occurred to me. We don't know squat.
Yeah, it's your set. Well, it's the green arrow on your map
there. I mean, when it comes to long-term survival. Like, I've got my dad's old notebooks, and I'm sure some people...
Better deal with this first.
Oh, boy.
I'm not knocking him to the ground anymore.
No, because you have a bladed weapon.
So that's... Okay, that's how that works.
Bladed weapon seems to be much more likely to just kill them outright.
To kill. Yeah,
like,
that's fine. I can deal with that.
And I'm sure some people here have at least worked on a farm. But if we had...
There you go. There's
material,
your tower.
We could do a whole lot more.
What happened?
Well, since we don't have the internet anymore, I'm thinking we should start assembling a reference library.
That sucks. Books on losing the internet.
Electrical engineering.
This is the time where I'd want the internet
the
worst.
Most.
We gotta start somewhere.
Hold up. Let's take care of this first.
I like that. That's good.
I think I can
yeah.
get a decent
Shut up your stupid
there.
Story conversation.
I'm doing a thing. It's really important, actually. So yeah, you climb over from the other side.
Can I, actually?
No, no, from the other side. Like, there's a dumpster against the fence, and there's no barbed wire on the other side.
Okay, and I can't... Oh, I can't jump that fence.
Yeah.
Okay. I was wondering how high it took me, because the last time I couldn't...
So remember how Your base had barbed wire pretty much all over the place, except for a couple spots that you could climb over.
Well, I didn't take a minute to look at that, but I'll trust you.
Well, they can climb over that shit, too.
Barbed wire? Really?
No. There's a couple spots that do not have barbed wire.
And they're intelligent enough to possibly find it, or they have to hoard into it?
No, they'll find it.
Their pathing will be like...
If you can occasionally come back, and there can be a couple... in the base, and they're fighting it off.
Okay, so you have to be smart about where
the basic thing that's actually super cool is that...
I'll take a look around.
So this is awesome!
Oh, wow!
This is so cool!
That's radical! Nice, you actually have to see it! Oh, fuck, that's really cool!
Dude, this game is really...
There's some great ideas
really
here.
Cool!
There's some really good ideas here.
But...
Gotcha.
Oh, wow.
But, like, look, that's a moving horde.
Yeah, clearly.
You put it on your map.
That's a lot of zombies.
This is way better than, fucking,
Assassin's Creed,
man. Because you have to see it. Cool.
Gotcha.
I don't think I've ever felt recon like this.
Yeah, it's super good. It's a very good way to do it. And this will change, like, houses will not change accuracy, right? But things like, vehicles,
items,
Shit like that,
and it tells you how much is in the area.
Hordes,
fuck a stupid eagle tower or whatever.
Like, no, fucking
called.
Do it.
Jumping off like a fancy ass, landing in some hay.
There we go.
And you see that there's only a couple that you have. See that when you do that, it's gonna have certain icons next to it.
Yeah.
So like places that you're likely to find a lot of food. Are gonna have a food icon.
Right.
Places that you're finding a lot of building supplies are gonna have a building supply icon.
Hey, what's that?
And food hasn't come up yet.
Looks
so.
Like a vet's office or something.
And also by doing it this way, you actually get the
what's
lay of the
happening?
Land in your head for real.
Well,
yeah.
Antibiotics for dogs aren't any different than antibiotics for people. And it looks like no one's broken in.
Antibiotics? Is that what
That's
people
a good
say?
Idea.
I don't know.
Okay. Sounds like it's worth checking out.
We Canadians.
So yeah,
biotics.
Your survival tactics thing just changed to I need to set my own goals.
Okay.
You might want to go check it out.
Squad goals.
Yeah.
I'm sending Alan and Sam to meet you at
the I'm
party.
Really close to that horde.
Alan.
Yeah.
Infestation,
Gee,
rather.
Thanks.
I haven't seen what that looks like. Is
and
it just
that,
a fuck ton?
It's a fuck ton, and there's screamers inside, and the screamers are the problem.
Oh, they make noise.
The screamers are ones that constantly make noise.
Okay.
And will give you troubles. So the vet office is a scripted event.
So, but there are zombie types.
Yes, there are zombie types. You will eventually, over time, unlock, like, bloated big tank guys.
Is nighttime more dangerous?
Nighttime is more dangerous because your visibility sucks and that's it.
Let's take care of this first.
But your visibility sucks.
Okay. And outside of that,
it is now nighttime. Well, our very beginning of nighttime.
Are lights a problem?
I don't remember. It's been too long. So, I remember sound being the number one concern by a million.
And we only got so much fuel to keep them running. So we gotta be careful about when we use them.
Like it? I don't like how I have to walk inside of a safe zone. Or rather, an exploration zone like this.
Yeah, I know.
Forced walking when combat is gonna pop up on me anyway.
You can see why I think this game is cool, but like, it's like, I stopped playing it after 7 hours because I hit a point where it's like the jank started to compound on itself. And I was like,
yeah.
So once you have.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
So yeah, that's some big materials. Also, your character is exhausted. They're very tired.
Oh, yeah, eh? Okay.
And you're encumbered now.
No. I want to ditch the shitty stuff. I'll just destroy that. Yeah. And then maybe one of these?
Yeah,
Radio home? What is that about?
So, if you call for scavengers...
They'll
come get shit from here. Like, you'll be like, I found a bunch of materials that I can't carry.
Cool, okay.
Come down here. Now, establish outpost. Is significantly more intense.
Yeah, it takes a lot of people to turn this into a safe zone.
And
yeah.
What that will, you will establish a semi-permanent base.
So there's more here than I can carry, so I think I want to call some dudes to come take this stuff.
Yeah, do it.
That's cool.
I found some supplies. Send runners for pickup.
Okay, I'll round up everybody that's available.
Okay, now...
And that's all that's left here. In this area, because there's...
And outposts are like, they will generate resources over time.
Oh, they refill.
Yeah, you're safe right now. Hit your map. I believe if you look carefully enough over time, you'll actually be able to see somebody go from the base on your minimap
towards
the thing and back.
In real time.
The main problem you're going to run into is there is very high likelihood that anybody that's going to come out here is going to actually cross paths with that infested zone. So you'll probably get a pop-up that says, yeah, there it is! That tiny little green dot is actually moving.
Oh, geez, you're in the infestation zone, dude. But he's not stupid.
No, not that dot. The tiny green dot. Look at the road.
Oh, I see it. Yeah.
Right, put the thing over it so that...
Hold on a second. There's a horde
coming. So you can see there's a lot of stuff you've got to handle there.
You've got to stop and think. Yeah.
I'm managing my people.
Yeah.
I'm getting resources.
And you know how I am.
Yeah.
So
your visibility is, like, starting to really, like, go down.
Now, that dot's coming towards this thing. He's going to avoid those areas.
Yeah.
Right? Okay.
If he's smart.
Then I'll trust you. And if you're stupid, then so be it. But that horde is a fucking problem. And you're right in my way.
You can get past it.
I'm sure I can. However.
When we end the video for Dead Day, I want you to fire a gun. Because... I really want to see what happens.
Now is this horde gonna turn its head a little bit?
They can occasionally.
Cause, I mean, I'm in the zone, but you know.
You see, they're all shambling over there. I like how they disappeared off your minimap once they were outside of your character's visual range.
Right.
Like they only get to be, visible. Well, since you're safe for the time being behind this rock, let's see how your buddy's doing. He was gonna go through the infestation zone.
He backed off.
And he was like, fuck that.
But he's about to run headlong into this horde.
So part of the reason why the jank is so jank is because the game is actually running a bunch of shit constantly.
Okay.
Like, it is running a sim
in the
background.
Yeah.
Characters are all doing their shit.
Yeah.
Zombies are all patrolling in their zones, and infestation zones are popping up.
Oh, boy. At that. Do you see that when I rotate the camera?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you're falling apart a little bit. Okay. I'm actually stuck here.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you can probably sneak past the horde at this point.
Let's go around the safe side. Oh, man. That horde is just a walking game over.
It's not that bad. You can deal with it.
This guy is going to be a bridge to the horde?
No.
No, no, I mean, like, if he sees me...
No, no, he would... No.
They won't?
The Horde acts as, like, a single unit in their stealth form.
Oh, okay, alright, fine.
Like, that vision cone is their fucking deal.
Okay. No, I saw you. So stop pretending.
Yeah.
What?
It's because you got too close to the vet place.
You're the newbie, so you get a bust.
So these guys all just showed up for story purposes.
The door will make less noise.
Fucking jerk.
Hey, you could do it like a total fucking idiot. Up to you.
Just get us inside.
Oh, also for shooting, headshot rule
always
is in effect.
Yeah,
which is awesome.
Make it count.
Because you can completely botch it.
Yeah.
Over and over.
It has to be a headshot.
It has to be a headshot.
Okay. Okay.
You can shoot them in the body all day.
So
you gotta break in somehow.
Yeah, she said the front door is stupid, so...
No, she said front door would make less noise, or you could go in like an idiot through the fucking window. There's a bunch of different things you can do here.
X is gonna force the door open.
Yeah.
Let's see our other options, because I don't like that too much. Move!
He doesn't care. He's the character with a cowboy hat on. That means he's an ass.
I'm in position.
Or he's a shitty kid.
Okay, so Marcus is the guy that ended up going to the diner. And he's searching in the current location.
Got it. Let me just...
Is he on the other side of the fence, or is he inside the fence? He's on the other side.
He's literally both. He's everything and nothing. No. No. Alright.
Oh yeah, hold LB.
I did.
And you get a bunch of options.
No.
Okay, he's freaking out.
This fucking game. Jesus Christ, dude.
It's trying! It's trying really hard,
and
Wooly.
It gets a star. It really does.
So your options are the front door, the back door, and the windows.
Try the back.
Might want to swing wide. We got some lift.
All right. That wasn't too bad.
He's not coming around. Okay, good. So.
Oh, he is coming around.
There he comes. You guys got it.
Yeah. I found that the AI in here is shockingly competent in terms of.
It would take me.
In terms of just. Oh, there's a zombie.
It would take me hours to figure that out.
I didn't realize the Department of Fish and Wildlife handled as a beat.
See? You decided to show up with, filled with shit.
Okay, well.
Yeah. And if we gotta deal with any zombie trout, you'll be the first motherfucker I call.
So they're here, by the way. They're
yeah. So just giving it to them is fine, right?
So tape it shut and keep loading.
Like they're banging against the front door.
Oh fuck!
Clear out the inside. What's up? Zombies on our left.
Okay, well. So now that she's all full.
Now lead the runners home. You did it.
Oh, okay. They took everything.
Yeah. There are zombies in here with you, by the way.
Yeah, okay.
You gotta basically constantly be checking that that minimap.
Alright.
Lots of them.
This way. Alright, let's see what we're looking at. Yeah, we can group this.
Boy, can you. Like, look at this. So they have the mega backpacks.
Yeah. So what I was gonna say is like when the game has a situation like that where I'm like I can't pick up shit right now.
Yeah.
All I can do is tell people about what's going on.
So what you do is you
switch
tell people or you go back and dump your shit.
Is switching to them a possibility?
Not right now. No. So look at your stamina. Notice it doesn't fill up all the way anymore.
Yeah.
It's because you're tired.
Okay. I'm also like halfway down on my health there.
Yep.
Would a top off like be the whole bar?
I don't know. Maybe. Whatever the health button is, I forget what it is.
Painkillers.
I'm headed home.
All right, Marcus did it.
What is that button? How do I heal myself?
Hit start.
Wait, hold on. I am right next to danger.
No, start. We'll pause it.
Okay.
It's gonna be use items. Use items, RB.
Okay.
Also, clicking on the right stick will cause your flashlight to go off.
That is a horde down there, and their vision cone is not showing up, but...
Uh-oh.
Someone in help? Someone needs help? No. Someone needs help, right?
Hit your map. That's the easiest way to check. Oh my god, Marcus.
Oh. Yo, I'm sorry, Marcus. Like, come on. Really?
He's fighting them off.
But I can't, dude. I can't survive that.
Too late. Horde's alerted.
So that's a double horde.
Yeah. So you can either leave him or do something about it.
He's done.
He's not done. You're just leaving him there.
Two hordes? Really? Okay, fine. All right, I'll trust you.
See, look, he's getting away from it.
Better get ready. We'll be on him soon. Keep going.
Yeah, that's it. So, I don't know if you can see your mini-map when that happens.
But wow!
The map just explodes with noise.
All right.
Well, he died.
All right, well, take his shit. What's the button for that? What's the button to take his shit?
I don't know.
Oh, okay, all right. All right.
Hatch broke.
I'm done.
So luckily, what happened was that every zombie in the area was already attacking Marcus. So what you can do if you're in too much trouble is hit that car.
Oh boy.
What did I say? No car.
Oh right.
So they're not gonna get in.
They're not gonna get in because for their story mission, he doesn't want to use a car.
I don't know if I can help you guys. Like,
you still got your gun, don't you?
It's with no weapons in it, really. It's fucking exhausted. All right.
Wait, I said you still have your gun and you go with no weapons in it?
Sorry, I have 30 bullets.
Yeah. There you go. And you just get that last one. There you go! You killed the zombie horde.
Oh. Never mind then, I guess. But his body's still there, right?
It should be. Yeah, basically firing a gun within, like a proper distance of that infested area
is gonna
will just cause, like, this endless amount. So in terms of this, like, they're always pretty much gonna keep coming.
Okay.
Like, they pretty much come from everywhere all the time.
Oh, I couldn't pick it up while they were there.
Yeah.
I'm
bringing the
stuff. Understood.
And that rucksack is, like, its own item.
Of shit that he picked up for me.
Yeah.
Okay, well, I hope
so. As you can see...
Are you following?
Yeah, they're following. As you can see, they're still, like, coming in general.
Hot and heavy. Oh, yeah. 1 out of 25.
That's your gun.
That's my gun.
Yeah.
Wide reload.
Ah! So pretty much all you have to do when that happens, that is them being downed. And you just have to get them off of them enough so they can keep moving.
Okay, let me actually hold out on that for a second. All right, let's go, guys. Can I command them to just come with me? Yeah, okay, there we go.
Yeah.
Just stop.
As long as they're not, like, swarmed, they'll follow you pretty mm-hmm. pretty.
And I don't want to waste on this my time
Uh-oh.
Sprinting. Oh, boy. I don't
so this is
yeah.
the this is the part of the game that I'm in love with,
yeah.
which is wandering through a suburb and, like, because it's the zombie scene of, like, you hop into a guy's backyard, right, and you peek around to the street and you see problems. You know, okay, well, I'll keep hopping backyards and then I'll cut through this house. Oh, there's medical supplies here. Okay, yada yada yada.
Yeah, I was totally gonna give up on him. I didn't realize you could actually fight off a horde like that.
Kiss my ass, Alan. Lily needs these meds.
So if you have people that have, like, diseases,
get your ass back here, Alan.
So at this point, Alan just split off from the group and she's like, just grab a fucking car. Which luckily there's one right there.
He just fucking bounced, huh?
Yep.
Wow, that's because he was sad.
Yeah. Well, no, this is a story mission. The vet area is a story mission, okay. So it's all. And he's just gonna.
Yes. He
piece of shithead, but look on the bright side. He's only about half as stupid as he looks.
So this one does not control the same, and I can tell because it accelerates like crazy.
Yeah. So I wonder if he's running back to our base or he's just...
He is.
Okay. He's just giving up. I can't tell if that's a path. It's not. Okay.
It is sure not. You're going to have to turn around. Hey, you want to see something cool? Yeah. Drive past it.
Really?
Yeah. And just look at what's going to happen to the map when you go back towards it. Jesus Christ, Wooly.
Nothing happened.
Oh, yeah? Oh, okay.
Oh, it got bigger? Is that what it does?
No. I think it's because you have to... Maybe you have to interact with it? I don't know. I thought for sure a billion guys were going to come out. Oh, you can turn your headlights on with right click. Right stick click. There you go.
I kind of want to see.
Yeah, let's see what happens when you... Oh, there it is. Now you can see them all on your map.
Oh, that's all the dots.
Yeah.
Okay, I see. So you just get a good look at,
Man, you are not a good driver.
I'm looking at my map right now. But yes, I'm also not a good driver.
None of us are. None of us drive cars.
None of us need to be. In fact, I think some sort of study came out and said that kids born today are probably never going to drive. How about that?
That's, well, because of the robots?
You know.
So you discovered a new survey point. You're finding shit all over the map.
Yeah, I am. I can actually climb up and take a look and see what's going on this side, eh?
Mm-hmm.
I like surveying, so let's do that, actually.
There it is. There's your tower.
Yeah, this car is pretty fast, actually.
Eventually you'll find cars that you're like, I like this car.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And if you take a look at your map and really zoom out, what you'll see is that, like, the area is pretty big. And there are, do me a favor and hit that map for a second. And zoom all the way out. So that little town at the top, at the right, in the right middle, is where you start the game. But, like, there's another one in the upper left, and there's another one in the bottom left. And the bottom left one's the end of the game, basically.
We started out here, and we drove down here. So we actually, it's not that huge.
Yeah, except when you're running shit at the church, and the guys two towns over are like, help.
Oh.
Made okay. It.
Help us right now.
Can I scope without a gun?
You'll just pull out binocs.
Yeah, okay. I haven't seen any, like, real visible nighttime things except for this light stuff.
Yeah, that's it.
There we go.
That's the main difference.
And, when I'm on a normal mission and I have a crew, right, a full crew.
Oh, that trailer park is a place you can hole up in.
Maybe. What character I'm using, no good. Probably gonna die right now. I can just switch to another on the hotspot and keep my mission
once
going.
If they're around and you're at the base, yeah.
Okay. If they're with me in the field, though.
Mm-hmm. They're with you in the field? Not sure.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I know.
Spotted a weird one.
Not ideal.
So you're spotting ferals and screamers now.
What is a feral?
I think they're the really hardcore, fast ones.
Big strongs? Big strong toughies, redhead?
I think the closest...
Crimson heads?
Crimson heads probably the best analog, in that they're tougher than the average.
Okay.
Like, considerably so.
Which side was
so you're still on a story mission, which is get in the car and go back to the house.
I just wanted to do that. And in fact, as long as I can, I think I would want to always scope, because that's a really fun thing to
it's
do.
It's super good, too. I know how to get back to there. You have to, you need to do a U-turn here.
Okay.
Now, follow this road.
All the way down?
Yeah, you're gonna take a right at this T-intersection.
Yep.
Like, that car moves so fast, it's making me fucking nervous.
You're right.
Then you're gonna want to take your first right. You blow through that horde if you like.
Woo!
You're gonna want to follow this to around the curve until you hit another T-intersection.
Yeah, you've gotta let up on the gas, basically, is how you gotta treat this thing. Alright. Blow through this horde.
Yeah. Keep going. Yeah, take a right at this T-intersection.
Okay.
And then keep going, and you will have the entrance to the church on the right. Or you should have. Hit the map. Oh, you passed it a little bit. Ah, my bad. There you go. Yeah, there's the entrance to the church down there.
Okay. Okay, yeah.
Fuck!
That looks pretty cool, actually. Yeah. Okay, so it's a little misleading because of the front door. Oh. Goodbye, cool car.
Cars will just break down.
And my other
so that other shitty
there.
Car. So, like, so yeah. This is what's gonna end up happening.
Thanks for the ride.
You're gonna if you decide to go out on foot, you're almost always gonna want to return on foot.
Yeah.
And if you want to leave by car, you're gonna want to always come back by car with as little damage. So it's a cool little thing where it's like, yes, you could just mow down that horde, no problem with the car, right? But then you can end up 18 miles away from your base with nothing.
And then I guess, like, if this church eventually gets overrun, at least we have some escape pods.
What the hell is going on here? Okay, look. I've got this condition. Lupus? It's chronic.
So that's basically the whole game.
Okay.
Right? A story mission here or there.
Yeah.
Find new outposts. There's like 8 to 10 outposts. There's a carnival. There's a you know, a bunch of shops. You gain outposts to gain supplies. You defend them. You send runners out. You build up your base.
I feel the rhythm of it. I feel the rhythm of it.
Like, oh yeah, recover to fallen allies backpack. You got everybody likes. It's like, it's a cool game.
That scouting is strong.
That is so jank.
That scouting is really strong.
Yeah, the scouting and the, oh, Lily's sad due to the loss of hope. You know what? Let's end the video, go down to the infestation site and see if you can clear it out.
You know what I'm looking for.
You're looking for that infestation site right there?
I'm looking for an out. I need an end.
Oh, there's a big end right there.
Is that the end of the video right
there? That's the end of the video. It's over there.
Right there on the map, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
This is a giant blood splatter. It's actually the house after this one. This one has a survivor in it.
You know, it's the first time I've ever seen the end of a video on the map.
It's weird, huh?
As an objective. It's quite
goofy. So you're exhausted now.
Oh, is she?
Yeah.
Oh. It's a pretty house.
So you're going to go in here.
Anybody home? Hello?
Somehow, that did not alert them.
Hey, party over here.
Hey, guys. Wow, what is going on with this?
Pat, this is kind of crazy.
What is up with this?
Are you kidding
me? Does it not work properly inside houses? That's hilarious. Okay, music is kicked in.
Oh, this stick aim is... That's my screamer?
Yeah, there's a screamer. Oh, your shooting leveled up.
That's cool.
Oh, bonus XP for shooting multi-kill. Well, I guess that's not the end of the video.
That's a slow-ass reload. Oh, God.
Yeah, headshot rules in effect makes me very happy about the shooting in this game. Any firearm will instant kill nearly any zombie in a single shot.
The lethality of this infestation was greatly overstated.
Yeah. There's still another zombo somewhere in here that you got.
I can't believe that worked. Oh boy.
Just walking in and popping him. I think it's that one guy in the back. Like in the
He's
backyard.
Outside,
yeah.
Hey friend.
Hey, what up? Shooting, popping them in the fucking head feels super good in this game.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. Oh, yeah, you can insta-kill them.
Well, shit.
Did you check out the upstairs?
No, I didn't. You're right. That's
because they usually have two screamers.
Okay. Well, I did kill two screamers.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I shot two of them hard.
We'll check out the upstairs. Make sure to clear it all out.
Oh, God.
I thought that... Oh.
I could have sworn that's not the upstairs.
Is there an upstairs? I feel stupid for even asking that question.
I mean, I didn't see a stairway, but no.
Okay, take a...
Over here?
Maybe. I guess you did it.
I cleared it out.
You did it.
Do-do-do.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-